And then I have World War II postcards that depict, you know, that World War II Jap, you know, with the buck teeth and slanted eyes, yellow skin, and they're endless depictions. You know, and I almost have all of them now. I must have about 30 or 40 of them. And other ones that are just really foul, dogs urinating on, you know, Jap heads and things defecating on them, and there are all these different versions. I have magazine advertisements of those same kinds of depictions. Jap hunting licenses, you know, that companies gave away. You know, you put stamps on them and, you know, how many Japs you kill. I have slap a Jap cards that were clubs that you would join, you know, and every time you're supposed to slap a Jap that you saw. Patriotics, which were envelopes that you used with images on there that were the stereotypes of Japanese people. So just about anything that had to do with depictions, negative depictions of Japanese people. You know. And of course, all of these things end up informing my paintings. So, you know, I've been working on a series called Stereotypes and Admonitions, where I depict myself sometimes as a samurai from a ukiyo-e woodblock print, because that refers to how people see me as the person from Japan, you know, or as that World War II yellow peril threat, you know, which is still that kind of an eternal foreigner, you know, but more of a threat. And so what I'll do is I'll put myself under one of those two disguises within a Western framework, you know. So it also, you know, refers to that idea of, you know, when you tell a white person that not a day goes by where you don't realize that you're not white, they don't understand what you mean, you know. And that's what this refers to, because it's so dramatized, you know, with these horrible depictions.